وأنيبوا إلى ربكم وأسلموا له من قبل أن يأتيكم العذاب ثم لا تنصرون. واتبعوا أحسن ما أنزل إليكم من ربكم من قبل أن يأتيكم العذاب بغتة وأنتم لا تشعرون. أن تقول نفس يا حسرة على ما فرطت في جنب الله وإن كنت لمن الساخرين. أو تقول لو أن الله هداني لكنت من المتقين. أو تقول حين ترى العذاب لو أن لي كرة فأكون من المحسنين. بلى قد جاءتك آياتي فكذبت بها واستكبرت وكنت من الكافرين. صدق الله العظيم. I don't know how many of us are at least aware of the fact that we started a new Islamic year. And now we are in the month of Muharram, the first month in the Islamic calendar. And the month by itself is a very important month, and especially for fasting. It is a month that carries a lot of virtues. Of course, it's also a month that carries a lot of history in it, and there are many important incidents in the history of Islam that took place during the month of Muharram. But of course, history will be the secondary, and the most important will be the ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam regarding the importance of it. Islam, since it came as a complete and perfect religion and deen, therefore we as Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and followers of Islam, we do not make any changes into it. We do not make any additions or deletions to the deen. And that is the reason we don't have any celebration for the beginning of the year and for a new year. As Islam already gave us our celebrations. But for the purpose of the ibadahs, we need to keep track of the Islamic month. And it's important for the Ummah to keep track of the whole, all 12 months, not only one or two months of the year. And reality speaking, if we really look at ourselves, how we forget about our month and the beginning and end of each month throughout the year, and then all of a sudden we wake up at the time of Ramadan and at the time of Eid al-Adha to put our opinions there and to give our suggestions about how should we spend these 2 months. If we would have followed the rest of the months of the year, we would never get into those kind of arguments. Because in that case, we would establish a method of starting the month and ending the month. Right now, we as an ummah, as a community, small community, we have not yet established how we are going to stand or end the month. They have not established it yet. How did the month of Muharram start? When did it start? What was the method of starting it? When is it going to end? How will we end the month? We have not established that yet. None of it is aware of it. We will hear an announcement in the masjid that it's the month of Muharram, we will just go with it. Then, now is Rajab, mashallah is Rajab. Then is Sha'ban, mashallah is Sha'ban, who cares? Now is Ramadan? No, I'm not going to take it. Now I'm not going to cross you. Now we won't accept that this is Ramadan. All of a sudden we see a change in our thoughts. The reason is, when always, remember, when we talk about unity in our deen, we have to realize what is unity. I think, and really, many times I think about this point, that how many times we think about unity and we talk about unity and we hold seminars about unity, but we have not even yet established what is the unity. If we ask ourselves and go around to find out what is the concept of unity in our mind, in each person's mind, believe me, with a masjid of 100, 200, 300 people, you will find those many opinions there. Because even the concept of unity has not been established in our minds. As an ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the person who was the most successful person ever existed in the world to unite the world and unite the ummah. Muslims and non-Muslims, everyone agreed to the point that no one was more successful than Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to unite such a large group of people within such a short time. But what concept of unity did he teach us? How are we going to be united? What is the way of being united? We have not yet established those concepts in our mind. We are not even aware of those concepts. And subhanAllah, sometimes it's amazing how when we sit for hours and discuss that we need to be united, and at the end we don't even know what unity is according to the Sharia of Islam. There are so many people out there also out of this masjid, I mean non-Muslims, who talk about unity. Who doesn't talk about unity? Tell me which community exists in the world that does not like to be united with others? Muslims and non-Muslims, all of them talk about it. And everyone wants unity. And for that reason, there are people out there who are coming with so many suggestions. Some of them are that every person should accept all the other religions as true religions. People are following it, mashallah, you are in the Jannah. You are a Jew, you are in Jannah. You are a Christian, you are in Jannah. You are a Hindu, you are in Jannah. Unity. This is how we are going to be together. Some people will say that putting men and women at the same level at every stage of the work, every stage of life, that will give us a better unity amongst the communities in the world. All of these are different concepts of unity that have been bombarded on us, and we, as an ummah, have not yet decided what type of unity we would like to choose for ourselves. And if we have decided that it will be the unity that Islam teaches us, then we don't know what that is. And we need to remember just a very briefly one point over here that might make the point clear to us and in our minds, and that is
Unity never means that you do exactly the same thing that I'm doing at this time, so then we are united. Unity simply means the concept of unity in my mind and your mind has to be the same, then we are united. If the concept of unity is the same, then we are united. If the concept is different, then even we are doing the same thing at the same time, we are not united. Example? And then Muslim comes into the masjid. And he says, you people are collecting donations for your mosque. We also have a majority of people out there who are Christians. So here I'll stand beside you and we both will collect donations. You collect it for your mosque, I will collect it for my church. We both go together for outside. We will approach as many people as we can, and we both will go together so we can show that we are united, Muslims and Christians are united. So you collect for your church, and I collect for your mosque, I collect for my church, and we all going to approve each other's work. Now you see they're doing the same type of work.